David, a very crucial win today against Saric with the white pieces, but you were in trouble the entire game. What happened?
I'm not sure about the entire game. That's a bit harsh. Actually, I avoided a repetition of moves, maybe around move 20, and it was probably stupid. I had about 10 minutes, he had 40, and I was feeling brave. So it was a calculated risk, but I knew I was in trouble at some point. I miscalculated his b4 break, and luckily I was just about holding on. And then I think best play was a draw, but yeah, he let me trick him at the end.
Did that pawn on a2 worry you at all?
I've had scarier positions, don't worry. It worried me, of course, but I think I'm just about holding.
Right. Now, like you mentioned, you actually had the option to repeat moves, but you declined the repetition the third time. Now, this is something we see you do pretty often. Repeat twice, but not for the third time. What's the psychology behind?
I mean, partly I'm gaining time on the clock, getting close to move 40. Partly I want to show them who's in control. I don't know. Most of the time, it's a calculated idea. I want to repeat three times, but today I just really didn't know what else I could do. So it was stupid to play a different move the third time, but luckily it paid off.
We've seen a lot of top players do this: change the repetition the third time.
Apparently, they're taught this in Russia just to assert dominance, to show who's in control. Apparently, like any time you get a chance to repeat, just repeat twice. Just don't do it the third time. Yeah.
Right, now, where do you think it went terribly wrong for him?
Yeah, his queen a3, just after the time control, actually. I saw him shaking his head, and then he played it quite quickly. I mean, after you get 50 minutes at the time control, and he spent only maybe 7 or 8, I think, on this whole queen a3 idea. And there was some clever line with rook c4. He gives up his knight on c3, and then he gets his rook on b1, and I have to sacrifice the exchange. It's complicated stuff, but he played it quite quickly, and that surprised me. If it were me, I would have been sitting there for 20 minutes, just making sure I calculated everything, and... Yeah, I mean, I'm a tricky guy. He should have realized that I had this trick prepared with rook takes a2.
Now, we were watching in the press room and a lot of comments from our viewers on your time control and your time management. What's going on there?
I've never heard that one before. It's bad. I mean, my New Year's resolution 2018 was to be better with this in life as well, never to be late, just to be more practical. But I'm late for every game and my clock handling's worse than ever. So I'll just have to deal with it, get used to it. Hopefully my fans don't have a heart attack watching.
Right, now Hikaru drew his game. You won yours. We're going to have a few leaders. And going into the last three rounds of the tournament, your thoughts, any special preparations?
No, I'll try and forget about the score. Like, I'll worry about who I'm playing tomorrow.
One game at a time?
Exactly. Cliche, but actually I came into this tournament with zero expectations. I think I mentioned last time I'm taking a big break after this, so we'll see. I'm still pretty chilled. I mean, if it all goes wrong, it all goes wrong. But I don't know. I'm pretty happy so far. Yeah.
You sound pretty modest, but at the end of it, you must be quite happy about your result today.
Yeah, I mean, I feel bad though. I mean, Ivan's a nice guy. He's a good friend of mine. We play on the same Bundesliga team, but yeah, I'll take the win. I'll take the lucky win. Yeah.
All right, we'll let you get some rest. Good luck for the rest of the tournament.
Thank you.
Thanks.